But first tonight, personal injury attorney Ken Riley, he's here to take a look at one of our email questions. And tonight's question comes from Tabitha. And Ken, Tabitha writes in telling us, she says, my son was bit by a dog bad enough to send us to the ER for shots and stitches. I've seen one of my neighbors feeding the dog, but he says it's not his. And we haven't seen the dog since. What can we do? So what do you think about that?
Well, I'm sorry this has happened. This happens from time to time. Everybody hears about dog bite cases, and there's always that one free bite rule, at least that people believe that's out there. But, you know, in a situation like this, the Alabama laws are pretty clear, and they're pretty strict in terms of proving a case where you can recover, or you could recover for your son or daughter for a dog bite. You got to be able to prove ownership, and I know that's one issue that you brought up. You don't know whether or not that's the person's dog or not, so you got to delve into that a little bit. You got to dig. The second thing is that dog must have vicious propensities. That dog must be a dog that's either known to be dangerous, or it has to be a dog that everybody knows is dangerous. For example, like a pit bull. A pit bull doesn't get a free bite. If a pit bull attacks you or someone in your family, then you've probably got a case against the owner. So those are the couple of things that you need to be looking at. That's something that very well could take an attorney to work out for you. Fortunately, in dog bite cases, homeowners insurance does cover those types of claims. So if there is a case, then you could probably access that homeowner's coverage.
For more information, head to Ken's website. It's deliveringjustice.com, or you can go to our website, wbrc.com, and click on the law calling there. Well,